Hi friends, in this video let us discuss the compositions of the relations. So first let us see the topics we have already discussed, the crisp relations and fuzzy relations and tolerance and equivalence relations of both crisp and fuzzy relations. So here in this video we will discuss only on compositions of crisp relations. Okay, that was shown in green color. Let us go ahead with the current topic. So what is the compositions? There are two types of compositions and let us discuss them, but before going to that, first let's see what is composition. Composition means let R be a relation that relates or maps the elements from universe X to Y. For example, if X and Y are the two universes and there are some elements in X and there are some other elements in Y, and in some of the elements in X are related with some of the elements in Y, then that relation is defined as capital R. And for example, if there is one more universe Z, now the some elements in Y and some elements in Z are in relation, then that relation is defined as capital S. Now our job is how the elements in X are related to elements in Z finally. Okay, same elements. Now let us see how they are related. Now we can define one more relation, that is capital T, where X is directly related to Z. Same elements, okay, same elements in X are related to same elements in Z. That's the thing. Now let us see if R is a relation, x1 y1 x1 y3 and x2 y4, or it is one of the relations from capital X and capital Y, where small x are the elements in capital X, universe capital X, and small y's are the elements in capital Y. Now this is one of the relations and this relation is named as capital R, and this has been given to us. And suppose if S is one more relation, and that is the relation from X universe Y to universe Z, and those are the some of the elements in Y, Y1 and Y3, and Z2 is one of the elements in Z. Let us see how these things are related. For that thing we are taking the help of sagittal diagram. We have already discussed this also. And in capital X, universe of disclosed capital X, there are three elements, x1, x2 and x3. And in capital Y, there are four elements, y1, y2, y3 and y4. And in capital Z, there are two elements, z1 and z2. Now, what are the elements which are related? Those are shown as arrow mark. So let us see. X1, Y1 are connected, so X1, Y1 are related. X1, Y3 are related, so X1, Y3 is connected with the arrow mark. And X2, Y4 are connected, related, so they are also connected like this. So this relation between X and Y is denoted as capital R. Now let us see what is capital S. So the capital S is relation between Y and Z. So from Y1, Z2. So Y1 to Z2 there is a relation, and from Y3 to Z2 there is a relation. So now my job is, this is relation S and this is relation R. Now I want to see the relation between X and Z directly. First, X is related to two elements, Y1, X1 is related to two elements, Y1 and Y3. Now I want to start from x1 and I want to end at any value in Z. So generally Z2 is connected with Y. So I want to start from x1 and I want to reach Z2 now. How can I proceed? So there are two ways. One is x1, y1, Z2 or x1, y3, Z2. That's the thing. So here I can develop one more relation, capital T, such that I can show x1 and z2 are the elements. So definitely the x1 z2 element belongs to capital T, where capital T is a one more relation related from capital X and capital J. Now we need to see how that relation will be developed. That relation will be developed by using composition. Okay, let us see how the composition will be. There are two types of compositions. One is max min composition, second one is max product composition. So this is the max min composition. As we know, I want to know the relationship between X and Z. So this is the capital X T of X comma Z is equal to max symbol of X R of X comma Y and min symbol X S of Y comma Z. That means from the relation R and from the relation S, I need to find out the minimum value, and then out of all these things I need to find the maximum value. Let us see by taking one example. In max product composition, the thing will be like this. It is XT of X comma Z is equal to max of XR of X comma Y dot or multiplication XS of Y comma Z. Very simple. So let us see by taking one example, then it will be very easy. This is the problem. So the matrix expressions of crisp relations have been given, and this is crisp relation R and this is crisp relation S. Now our job is to find out capital T by using max min composition. Here we need to see, just like the matrix multiplication, if it is a matrix, the order of this matrix is 3 by 4, as 3 rows are there and 4 columns are presented. So it is 3 means number of rows and 4, that means number of columns. So 3 by 4 will be there. And coming to S, there are 4 rows and 2 columns. So it will be 4 by 2. According to matrix, just like matrix multiplication, if 4 and 4 will get cancelled, then I will get 3 by 2. So I can say that my composition capital T of composition of R and S should be is a matrix having the order 3 by 2, just like matrix multiplication. Okay, 3 by 2, and we need to see in the same manner, such that, okay, first I want to show you the result exactly, so that we can come back again. This is the exact result. So here in this matrix, this is 3 by 2 matrix, I want to find the first element x1 and z1. Okay, let us see how the x1 and z1 will be found out. X1 and z1, I want to know x1 and z1. So x1 means all elements in this x1 row, and z1 means all elements in this z1 column. Now I need to see the things. Okay, let us first find out, it's a max min method. So first I need to take the elements like this, maximum of 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0. I will explain, just wait. Now I need to see max min method of composition from R to S, and I want to find out the element x1 and z1. So x1 means this row and z1 means this column. So here the first element is 1 from R, and from S the first element is 0. So I need to find the minimum of these two. The value is 0, and the second element is 0, and the second element in S is 0. So minimum of these two, the value will be 0. And the third element is 1, and the third element in S is 0. So the minimum of these two is 0, and fourth element is 0 from R, and the fourth element from S is 0. So the minimum of this is 0. So I found 4 zeros. Now I have to go ahead with maximum. So maximum of all the four zeros is again this 0. So the final value will be 0. Okay, this is the case. Okay, I will show you once again. Yeah, this is the thing. Here we need to, just like the matrix multiplication, we need to take first row, I mean rows of the first composition and columns of the second composition, and we need to find like this. Like this, yeah, this is the second element, I mean second element in the first row. This is third element, that means second row, first element, second row, second element, third row, first element, and third row, second. So these are the things. So if you have any doubts, please write in the comment box. Okay, this is very simple. Just like matrix multiplication, we need to see the minimum of the two things. One is the in this minimum, the first element comes from composition R, in the second element, the first element comes from relation R, in the second element comes from relation S. Okay, after that, first we need to see the minimum of them, and then we need to see maximum of them. So with this, maxmin method will be completed. Okay, all these elements will come out. So finally, this is our answer. So this is a relation by seeing two relations. So this is called a composition. So composition by using maxmin method. Of course, max product method is also the same for crisp values. So let us go ahead with the next thing. Yeah, so this is the basic understanding of the composition. The composition means it's the relation between the two relations. That means if a relation is related from X to Y and the other relation is related from Y to Z, now by using composition we can get the relationship between X to Z. Okay, there are two methods. One is max mean method, second one is max product method. But for crisp values, these two methods are same. So we have discussed only max mean method. Okay, coming to this, so thank you so much for 1100 plus subscriptions. And if you like this video, please like it. And if you have any doubts in this video, please write in the comment box so that I can answer your doubts. And if you like this video, please like it. If you want to share with your friends and family, please share with your friends and colleagues. And if you haven't subscribed till date, please do subscribe and try to press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any new video. Thank you. Thank you one and all.